now we're going to pass the peace of the elder monk.
To go out into the world
understanding of, actually hungry than me, which is a mystery of that. Why that was. And they thought it was all very funny, so, you know, I was a grunt of the and then this is where, before mealtime, we gather and you can kind of see that this is the dorm, what the dormitory we stayed in looked like. We gathered up before our meals outside, and then someone decided which way we would go. And then this is lining up to eat. We ate outside. Everybody had a job. And so somebody set up the tables and chairs, someone set up the table with food, someone set up the tables to wash the dishes when we were done outside. All this is outside. And this this is their lovely little faces in the morning. I took the first picture, they're all so sad. Not that they have a choice, but they look better. So we took another picture of them, so that shows them eating together. And this is the trade-off that hung around there. They were told that it was very hard there not to pet them. They aren't vaccinated, they aren't spayed neutered, they're a pack of dogs that live there. They're very friendly, they want you to pet them, and this was the hardest thing, is to there at the work sites not to pet the dogs. There was a told them how many times, 40 times, 50 times, don't do that. But these are some of the dogs and then some of our guys standing there. Louis's. This is Dobby. This is one of their favorites. Just really wanted to be loved. And so, but you know, can't pet them, so but we read them. And this we're going to talk about in a few minutes. We'll go back to this. So you can just, is there one more after this? This is the schedule. If you notice, it starts at 6 a.m. and it ends at 9 a.m. And it's getting up, going to the spiritual awakening for some of our people with our group right there. In the mornings at 6:15, and then you did your group did whatever your job was, gatekeeping around the buckets in the afternoon, you got to clean the bathrooms a little bit, breakfast, and then cleaning up, and then went to the work sites. Lunch was at 12:30, we were back to work, had a little free time in the afternoon, dinner, evening, sometime in the program. So it was a busy day. They had a little bit of free time, but they kept everybody busy. So the other thing I'll jump real quickly is about the net formation. Yapate is a greeting in Navajo that I would practice. But Silver, who is from the Navajo Nation, he works with SSP every year. We were in the city of Sale, which is, it's a tea, but it's named Sale. It is the college, people that live there, and one gas station. That's it. That's all there is. It's one gas station with a little market, and then you just eat. The next town is about 20 minutes or half hour away. So there they work with the Dene tribe. They work with the Sale, Wheatfields, Black Rock, and Lakachina chapters. So we went to one of the chapter houses and had dinner. This is basically their community center, and each of the things that they have, and they gather there. That's kind of where their government is. We learned that their clans, so where we work, there's probably a house where the mom and the grandma lived, and then the rest of the family all lived in the same area. And their houses always faced, the dome always faced the east. We'll talk about it later. But we saw people who had electricity, people without electricity, people with not heat, some building they didn't, so they could store wood. So they're there. It's a beautiful place. It's very remote, and there's not that many opportunities for them. So there's agriculture, and then there's issues with water and a lot of things. So we were very lucky to be there and to be with them. So that's it. So now, if you guys want to get ready, that would be good. So every year, SSP does a cheer, and it goes to the music. So they've done before, so they're going to come up. I'm sorry, Dan is around here today.
So I guess we'll demonstrate that.
Is sung at SSP, and I remember going all the way back to Molly and Stephen, and that that group. So it's great to see this new group also attached to it. It's to the song. The melody is not the Amazing Grace we're used to hearing. It's to the melody of the House of the Rising Sun. So some of you probably remember that tune. So we invite you to sing. Stand and sing with us on Amazing Grace.
I can't say that.
Oh, they greeted us with like people like standing on cars. They were very welcoming. And now I'll tell you about my work site. So I was a little bit on the bigger side of the group, I would say. Mine was like this very hard name. I forgot the name. I have no idea. But it was like all our first names like together. But we were working on a shed that was already like half completed. And me and Aaron did like hard work days of like painting. And I would get tired and Aaron would continue. And then I would be like, and then I got to do some drilling. And I was a little bit skeptical working with my brother, but we got along pretty well. And but after the work sites, there was free time. When we got back, we would take our showers, and then we would just get to like have free time and connect with the other people that were there. And I thought that was really special because it did make some core memories. And the staff there are really nice, and I would have like this thing with one of the counselors named Dawson, and I would have like call his name like specifically, and he'd like look back at me weird. But yeah, so we completed our works, our shed, a couple days early, so we moved on to a ramp. That was really fun. The dogs there were nicer from the shed site. I was kidding, this one dog that bit Dawson like a week before. The food there was pretty good. I just really loved making core memories with all my friends that I grew up with, and I'm definitely going next year. So.
Yeah.
This summer, my mom and dad thought me going to SSP would be a great way to branch out and meet new people. Although all the positive feedback I heard from the 1 week trip from other people's experiences, I was still hesitant on going. As the night before the trip came, all of a sudden, I was super excited. I was thinking about spending a week with people I love and care about and couldn't wait. But as the following morning arrived, I was super scared and wasn't sure anymore. As I laid in bed and upset with the situation, I got a text message from Bella, saying, "Aaron, we're going to have the best time. I'm so excited and I can't wait to see you." And that's when I realized this trip was going to be fun. The first night I had trouble sleeping because my nerves were everywhere, but by the next morning I realized this was a positive and fun environment, and I knew it was going to be hard to say goodbye in the end. I learned so much about myself within this week, like who I am away from the influence of other people. I met new friends, learned lots, and overall grew as a person. As the last day became a reality, I was super torn with the thought of leaving. The people, the community, and my friends truly made this trip feel like I had a home away from home. As we said our goodbyes, it was emotional, and that's how you know this trip truly meant something to me. I'm so glad I was forced into this, because now next year I'll be going willingly. Thank you.
Going to strengthen the tree this week. And so we want to pray for the trail marked with pollen, may I walk. With dew about my feet, may I walk. With beauty before me, may I walk. With beauty behind me, may I walk. With beauty below me, may I walk. With beauty above me, may I walk. With beauty all around me, may I walk. In old age, wandering on a trail of beauty, lively, may I walk. In old age, wandering on a trail of beauty, living again, may I walk. My words will be beautiful.
Now join us in the prayer that we say every week. You can use whatever word you have for God that's comfortable for you. Please join me in the Lord's Prayer. Our Redeemer, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
We can make a difference. Blessed is the one who trusts in the Lord, whose confidence is in him. He will be like a tree planted by the water that sends out its roots by the stream. He does not fear when heat comes, his leaves are always green. There is no worries in the year of drought, and never fails to bear fruit. With the hearing of God's words, we are blessed.
May the Spirit help us.
There was a lot of work.
took her picture, she said, so you want a picture of an Indian? I said, no, I want a picture of you because you've been so gracious and kind to us. And we're going to talk about it at church, and all the youth are going to talk about it. She was like so taken aback by, you know, like that would be, she's just a person. But it's interesting what she said. So we had a good week. We really got a lot done, as you can see, and everybody did their part of what that was. So I think that was our group and what we did. And these are some group pictures. If we're just going to go through these real quick. So this is when we were at the Canyon, Shelley National Monument. We went there for a spiritual walk on Thursday night. So every Thursday, every SSP, every group one night goes out and does a spirit walk. And you go from station to station, and you get to, the staff tells their story. There's a place where we share beads with each other, and of course I cry because, you know, I love them all so much, and I gave them all beads, and the other people that we met that week, since there was only two groups, it was pretty easy, it was a lot easier to meet everybody. So that's, this is Canyon Shelley, which is a very good, it's kind of, it reminded me of Grand Canyon, but not hardly anybody lives there, but you go back way back in that corner back there, people living there. So people actually from the Navajo Nation work with the parks system of the United States, and they live there. If we come down here longer, there's a place to take a tour of it too. People actually live there. It was beautiful. We saw maybe four of the couples there. This was like down below. You go down this thing, and you could go down there, and that was our group down there. And by the way, there was a place called the White House, which is they don't have an open public anymore, but where they lived in the dwellings, and they have that there. They also have a monument there that's called some kind of massacre. I'm sorry. What happened was all of the Navajos were hiding in there. When the U.S. troops came, it was afterwards, so they just started shooting, and they killed everybody but the babies. So there's a lot of history there. It's beautiful places in the middle of Grand Mesa. It's in the middle of nowhere. I'm trying to teach them how to use a real map. Circling out this map, where we went to Salem, isn't even on this map. Thank God for Google Maps. Google Maps found it, but it's not even on the map. That's how small it is in the Navajo region. This is when we were leaving. So that dorm right there, that's exactly what we stayed in when we got. That was round. We all went right outside of there. This is we're getting ready to leave. Here the dogs are saying goodbye. We're saying goodbye. So we're packing up the cars. This is before we parted. We met in Cleveland. I went to Dutch Brothers because we're going to try that. They want to try that. But this is before we parted cars. And they drove the rest of the 5 hours and made the grace of the and ran a state of the Cleveland Church again there. This is a sunset. It rained one night and it was just amazing. Bella has some pictures. She's took. I'm sorry, I don't have all the pictures on because it's too many. But I'll get them to everybody. But this was the sunset the night it rained. And it was red and orange. It was rainbow too. Yeah, it was beautiful. And here they are at the front of the shirt before we parted ways again. And left. And said goodbye to Paul and Matthew. I will say that one little thing there again. Say that what came out of this is that we made friends with Pastor Karen, who was amazing. Thank you so much for coming. It was her first experience. She got to the site. She came back. She said, Janice, I know nothing about construction. What in the world? There will be someone from the staff who will be there to help you. Hopefully, we have one or two of you that know what they're doing. But we're going to, since we've made friends with them, we're going to combine our groups and do things together now with locking out of them. Matthew's at Baldur's Gate, so we'll try to get one here once in a while. But the good thing that came out of that, we branched out and we are going to combine our groups and do some things together. Okay. Bella will tell her thing about the groups. You speak on your mind. And I guess it went really nice because we all got Use their best. And
You can't.
everything, and most of the songs that we've done well. Thank you for giving that. To the congregation in general, who donated your money, bought at the big sale, we paid for every single thing we did with our church. You're also generous. You encouraged me and emails and the last minute bringing money to my house. And so I can't tell you how much love I have for these youth and for all of you. Thank you. And I don't think it's Pastor Luis and Kim and Al who came and said goodbye.
Pray that your heart, mind, soul, and spirit will not forget to look upward this day to the one who is so much greater than we are. Turn downward and touch our Mother the Earth. Pray that everything you do this day will be in honor and reverence of our Mother.